Good afternoon. This is Dr. Eidelberg, and today's episode will discuss finite element analysis using Autodesk Inventor. We'll open up Autodesk Inventor. We start a new part. We choose standard millimeters. The part is now going to open. We start 2D sketch in the XY plane, and we'll place a rectangular cross section. We'll dimension it as 20 millimeters on the width and constrain it, and then we'll dimension it 100 millimeters on the height and constrain it. Now we're ready to finish the sketch and extrude it to 1000 millimeters. We now have a cantilever beam that we could do the analysis. Before we do the analysis, we have to assign material to the part. So we come over here, where before we do that, we want to start the analysis with this icon. And we want to create a study on the other side. We choose static analysis and we click OK. Now we have here the material assignment with this icon. We choose a certain material, in this case aluminum 6061. We click OK, and we are ready for the constraint. So we click the fixed constraint at this end of the beam, and we apply it. So now this end is fixed. And then what we like to do is to apply a force in this area. And you see that the force is going in the X direction, but we like to apply it vertically. So we come over here and we use the vector components in a Y direction. We'll make it positive 1000 newtons. Click apply, and now the force is actually ready to be applied over here. We're now ready to simulate. We run, and the results show us that the beam has deflected as expected upwards. The stress is maximum at the fixed end, and it's 28.84 megapascal. When we check the displacement, we see that this end has displaced 2.92 millimeters. This concludes our episode. What we will do now is we will use this information to run a similar analysis with LISA, Finite Element Analysis Tools, and compare it also to an analytical solution for the same problem. Thank you.